Colorado is, it's a good place for us. We're pretty well known. We've probably played more in Colorado than anywhere else. And we get to do something out there that we don't get to do in a lot of other places.
I'm a long way from home. I don't know where I'll go.
We tend to be able to be a little more progressive and a little more free with our jams and stretching out in Colorado than we would be in a traditional festival on the East Coast.
Being in this band, to me, is what I've always wanted to do.
Our sound really calls for, you know, everyone's originality on their instrument, which is just, that's just sort of what kind of defines the Stringdusters.
Is we do tons of improvising, but it's all within a very set form of each song.
The idea behind this band was to be able to do your own material and create the music how you want it to be created, rather than taking direction from a guy that wanted you to play his music his way.
And so for us to get to go out and play the music we want with people that we really enjoy, and the fan base are our people. You know, if you like the music we play, then you're gonna like us.
The infamous Stringdusters are a band from Nashville. You could call them a bluegrass band, but you know it's a lot more complicated than that. What do we know for sure? Well, there's six of them. Six longtime friends who were sidemen for other artists before coming together a couple years ago to form one of the most talked about bands in bluegrass music. In March 2007, the Stringdusters released their debut album on Sugar Hill Records. Then a few days later, they got in a van and set out on a two-week, 11-day tour out west. This is the story of what happened.
Lions on the face, growing day by day. I'm